In this video, we will review solving quadratic equations by factoring, by extracting square roots, by completing the square, and by using the quadratic formula. In this equation, we solve a quadratic by factoring. We're going to solve the equation 3x squared plus 2x equals 5. Now you're tempted to just factor that right away, because that's what we're supposed to do, right? Factor the x out, but no. Before you factor, you have to move all terms to one side. We do that by subtracting 5 from both sides. And that gives us 3x squared plus 2x minus 5 equals 0. Now we factor this. And this factors as 3x plus 5 times x minus 1 equals 0. Well, now because this is equal to 0, we can apply the zero product law, letting each factor equal 0. We get 3x plus 5 equals 0. And x minus 1 equals 0. Now we solve each of these equations. 3x plus 5 is solved by subtracting 5 from both sides, the subtraction property of equality, giving us 3x equal negative 5, and then dividing both sides by 3, the division property of equality, giving us a solution of x equal negative 5/3. Our other equation, x minus 1 equals 0, is solved simply by adding 1 to both sides, and we get x equal positive 1. We're going to do an example of solving a quadratic by extracting square roots. We're going to solve the quadratic equation 2x minus 5 quantity squared plus 5 equals 3. The first step in doing this type of problem is to get your equation in the correct form. You have to get the squared quantity isolated on one side of equals and some numerical value on the other. We do that by subtracting 5 from both sides, and we get the quantity 2x minus 5 squared equals negative 2. Now we extract square roots, which essentially is taking the square root of both sides of the equation. We square root the left side, which cancels out the squared. We square root the right side, but we also include a plus and minus to account for the negative solution, because a negative squared will square out to a positive amount. Okay, after we do this, we get 2x minus 5. The square is canceled out, equals plus or minus the square root of the right side. Now the square root of negative 2 ends up being a complex value. It's I times the square root of 2, where I is the square root of negative 1. Now we just have to solve this for x. Well, we do that by adding 5 to both sides, giving us 2x equal 5 plus or minus the I square roots of 2. And then we divide both sides by 2, and we get x equals 5 plus or minus I square roots of 2 divided by 2. In this problem, we're going to solve a quadratic equation by completing the square. Our quadratic is 3x squared minus 5x minus 7 equals 0. It's going to have a lot of fractions in it, but this is the kind that gives students problems, so I wanted to do one like this. The first step is to isolate the x squared in x terms. We can do that by adding 7 to both sides of the equation. This gives us 3x squared minus 5x equals 7. Our next step is to get the coefficient on x squared equal to 1. We can do this either by dividing both sides by 3 or multiplying both sides by 1/3. Either way, we get x squared minus 5/3 x equals 7/3. This is always how you start completing the square. You can do either of these first two steps in either order, but you always want to get 1x squared, and you want to have the x squared and x terms on one side of equals. Your next step is to add this special amount to both sides that's going to make the quadratic into a perfect square. You always take half of the coefficient on x. In this case, the coefficient on x is 5/3. Half of 5/3 is the same as 1/2 times 5/3, which is 1 times 5 over 2 times 3. That's 5/6. Then we take that amount that we got and we square it. Squaring 5/6 is the same as 5/6 times 5/6. That makes 25 over 36. So we add 25/36 to one side, add 25/6 to the other side. Now in this same step, I'm going to simplify the right side by getting a common denominator. If we multiply 7/3 by 12 over 12, we get 7 times 12 is 84, over 3 times 12 is 36. We can then add that to our 25/36 and make it into a single fraction of 109/36. Now, on the left side, you should have a perfect square, because that's what this process does. It gives you a perfect square. We can factor our quadratic into x minus 5/6 times x minus 5/6. And here's a little hint. That quantity in the binomial, the 5/6 and 5/6, that's always going to be the square root of that special amount you added. So here we added 25/36. The square root of that is 5/6. It's always going to work out that way. Now we can rewrite this all as x minus 5/6 quantity squared equals 109/36. We now have an equation we can solve by extracting square roots. It's in the form. We take the square root of both sides, and we get x minus 5/6 equals plus or minus the square root of 109/36. We can write the square root of 109/36 as the square root of 109 over the square root of 36, and that square root of 36 turns into 6. So our simplified form is x minus 5/6 equals plus or minus the square root of 109 all over 6. Now to solve, we just add 5/6 to both sides to get x by itself, and we get x equal 5/6 plus or minus the square root of 109 over 6. And since they both have a denominator of 6, we can easily combine them together and write it as x equal 5 plus or minus the square root of 109 all over 6. And if you solve this equation with the quadratic formula, that's what you'll get just as well. And some people ask, well, why complete the square then? Well, completing the square has a lot of value in calculus and other advanced classes. We oftentimes want to write a quantity in a perfect square form, and this is the way to do it. So this procedure has a lot of applications besides solving quadratics. The final method we're going to look at for solving quadratic equations is to use the quadratic formula. This is probably the easiest method to use because it just involves plugging coefficients into the formula, x equal negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac over 2a. One of the things students forget, however, is you first have to have your equation in the form ax squared plus bx plus c equals 0. Here in our example, we have an equation x plus 3 quantity squared equals x plus 2. Well, we got to do a bit of work here before we can use the formula. We have to multiply all the terms out on the left, and we do that with the distributive property, and we get x squared plus 6x plus 9 on the left equals x minus 2 on the right. Then we have to subtract x from both sides and add 2 to both sides, and that gives us the equation x squared plus 5x plus 11 equals 0. Now it's in the form where we can use the quadratic formula. The coefficient on x squared is a equal 1, the coefficient on x is b equal 5, and the coefficient of the constant term is just c equals 11. So we just plug those values into the formula, and we get x equals negative 5 plus or minus the square root of 5 squared minus 4 times 1 times 11 all over 2. And this gives us negative 5 plus or minus the square root of negative 19 over 2. And the square root of negative 19 can be written as the square root of positive 19 times I, using the definition of I. So this gives us an answer x equal negative 5 plus or minus the square root of 19 times I all over 2.